हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक विच इज़ सॉलिड स्टेट. इन योर फर्स्ट मॉड्यूल सॉलिड स्टेट इज़ अ टॉपिक विच यू हैव ऑलरेडी रेड इन योर 12th क्लास. व्हाट आर द सॉलिड्स? एज वी नो दैट, व्हाट आर द सॉलिड? सॉलिड इज डिफाइंड एज दैट द फॉर्म ऑफ मैटर विच पजेस रिजिडिटी एंड हैंस पजेस अ डेफिनेट शेप और डेफिनेट वॉल्यूम. वी कैन से दैट दिस इज अ सॉलिड विच इज हैविंग डेफिनेट शेप, डेफिनेट शेप एंड अ डेफिनेट एंड अ डेफिनेट वॉल्यूम. वॉट आर द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ सॉलिड्स? We know that there are two types of solid. Classification of solid. There are two types of solids, in which one is the crystalline solids, and other one is the amorphous solids. This crystalline solid. What are the crystalline solids? A solid is said to be crystalline if the various constituents particles like atoms, you can say ions or molecules, are arranged in a definite geometric pattern within the solid. We can say that in definite geometric pattern, definite geometric pattern within the solid. This is crystalline solid. Within the solids. And what are the amorphous solids? Amorphous solid is said to be amorphous if the constituents particles are not arranged in any regular fashion. Or we can say that no regular arrangement. So what are the solids? Solids are having the definite shape and definite volume, and two types of solid: crystalline, amorphous. Crystallines having the geometric pattern within the solids, and amorphous solids are the no regular arrangement of these solid. But the properties of the solids depend upon their structure and the nature of bonding involved. Okay, so it depends upon the structure of the solid. Then next is the space lattice. We will talk about only the cubic lattice. Okay students, always remember in your syllabus only cube is okay. There is only cube you have to read. What is the space lattice? What is the space lattice? We can say that arrangement of, we can say, atom, group, particle, molecule, whatever you want to say, you can say such a regular arrangement of constituents particles of a crystal in a three-dimensional space is called the crystal lattice or space lattice. Or we can say that in three-dimensional space, arrangement of atoms or groups is known as a space lattice. So what is a space lattice? Space lattice is the atoms, particles, molecules, arrangement of atoms, particles, molecules are arranged in a three-dimensional space is called the crystal lattice or space lattice. And what is the unit cell? What is the unit cell? Suppose, what is the space lattice? If there is any building, like if we will see any building, दिस इज द स्पेस लैटिस अरेंजमेंट ऑफ एटम्स और ग्रुप इन थ्री डायमेंशनल स्पेस. बट ओके स्टूडेंट्स, तो वेर एवर द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ एटम्स और ग्रुप्स इन थ्री डायमेंशनल स्पेस, वॉट इज द यूनिट सेल? वॉट इज द यूनिट सेल? अ यूनिट सेल इज अ स्मॉलेस्ट रिपीटिंग यूनिट, स्मॉलेस्ट रिपीटिंग यूनिट. इन वन वर्ड आप यू कैन से दिस इज द स्मॉलेस्ट रिपीटिंग यूनिट, और वी कैन से दैट द स्मॉलेस्ट थ्री डायमेंशनल पोर्शन ऑफ ए कंप्लीट स्पेस लैटिस विच वेन रिपीटेड ओवर एंड अगेन इन थ्री डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन प्रोड्यूसेस द कंप्लीट स्पेस लैटिस इज कॉल्ड द यूनिट सेल. और वी कैन से दिस इज द स्पेस लैटिस एंड दिस इज द स्मॉलेस्ट यूनिट सेल विच रिपीट अगेन एंड अगेन इन थ्री डायमेंशनल स्पेस इज कॉल्ड द स्पेस लैटिस. एज यू ऑलरेडी हैव नो दैट इन योर 12th यू हैव ऑलरेडी रेड दिस टॉपिक. दिस इज द स्पेस लैटिस इन थ्री डायमेंशनल स्पेस. दिस इज द स्मॉलेस्ट यूनिट विच रिपीट्स अगेन एंड अगेन इन थ्री डायमेंशनल स्पेस इज कॉल्ड द स्पेस कॉल्ड द यूनिट सेल. Then the size and the shape of the unit cell is determined by the length of the edges of the unit cell A, B, C or by the angles alpha, beta, gamma between the edges. So, in your syllabus, only cube. Okay, students, this is the cube. This is the cube. And these are the A, B, C, or we can say that alpha, beta, and gamma. These are the bond angles. Okay, so types of next is the what is the space lattice? What is a unit cell? And unit cell makes this whole space lattice in three dimensional space. Next is the types of unit cell. Types of unit cell. There are two types of unit cells. Primitive unit cell. और नॉन प्रिमिटिव यूनिट सेल. व्हाट आर द प्रिमिटिव सेल्स? प्रिमिटिव सेल्स आर द इन विच एटम्स आर प्रेजेंट ओनली एट द कॉर्नर ऑफ द यूनिट सेल लाइक दिस. एटम्स आर प्रेजेंट ओनली एट द corner of the unit cell. This is the primitive unit cell. Atoms are present only at the corner of the unit cell. This is the primitive unit cell. And the what is the example? Example is simple cubic. This is the simple cubic. What is the next one is the non-primitive unit cells. This is the non-primitive unit cell. Three types. What are the non-primitive unit cells? Non-primitive unit cells in which atoms are not present only at the corner but also present within the body or face or end of the unit cell. In case of primitive unit cell, only at the corner. But in case of non-primitive unit cell, not only at the corner, but also प्रेजेंट विद इन द फेस और विद इन द फेस और बॉडी ऑफ द यूनिट सेल, बॉडी ऑफ यूनिट सेल. तो स्टूडेंट्स व्हाट इज द प्रिमिटिव? ओनली एट द कॉर्नर. व्हाट इज द नॉन प्रिमिटिव? नॉट ओनली एट द कॉर्नर बट ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट विद इन द बॉडी और फेस ऑफ द यूनिट सेल. तो दिस इज द देर इज वन एग्जाम्पल. I am making this is present not only at the corner means corner present on the corner but and the body of the unit cell which is known as body centered cubic. Body centered cubic and other one is this is the face and the atoms are present in the face of the unit cell. This is face units, face centered cubic. Face centered cubic. And there is also one type of unit cell, one type of which is known as end centered. As like body centered cubic, face centered cubic, as there is one also present in different symmetry in orthorhombic, there is end centered is also present, which is end centered. Okay students, but in case of cube only three types of unit cells are present. Always remember, in your syllabus only cube, then in case of cube there are three types of unit cells are present. One is the simple cubic, other one is the body centered, and third one is the face centered cubic. Okay, and this is the types of unit cells. I have told you primitive and non-primitive. In case of primitive there is SC, in case of non-primitive it may be body centered, face centered and end centered. But in case of cubic unit cell, in case of cubic only three types of unit cells are present: simple cubic, body centered and face centered cubic. Okay, then next we will calculate the total number of atoms per unit cell. Okay, in case of simple cubic, in case of body centered, in case of face centered. The topic is, write down, calculation of number of particles. Calculation of number of particles per unit cell of a cubic crystal system. Okay, so we have to calculate the total number of atoms per unit cell in case of simple cubic, in case of face centered, in case of body centered. So first one, simple cubic. Simple cubic. In case of simple cubic, this is a primitive type of unit cell. इन विच एटम्स आर प्रेजेंट ओनली एट द कॉर्नर ऑफ द यूनिट सेल, ओनली एट द कॉर्नर ऑफ द यूनिट सेल. ऑलवेज रिमेंबर एन एटम एट द कॉर्नर इज शेयर्ड बाय 8 यूनिट सेल. एन एटम, प्लीज रिमेंबर, एन एटम, आई एम राइटिंग एन एटम एट द कॉर्नर इज शेयर्ड बाय 8 यूनिट सेल्स, 8 यूनिट सेल्स. देन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ ईच एटम प्रेजेंट एट द कॉर्नर, देन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ ईच एटम प्रेजेंट एट द कॉर्नर. Then this is, suppose this is the, there is one atom, there is one corner of the unit cell, and from this all the units are joined, and what is the contribution of each atom at the corner? The contribution of each atom, so we can say contribution of each atom, like this one, contribution of each atom present at the corner, is equal to 1/8. Always remember the contribution of each atom present at the corner is 1/8. Therefore, number of atoms present in the unit cell, or we can say total number of atoms per unit cell is equal to total, how many atoms are present in cube? 8, and contribution from each corner is 1/8. It means the answer is 1. And in case of simple cubic, what will be the answer? Number of atoms present in the unit cell is equal to 1. Okay, so this is the, in case of simple cubic, there is answer 1, contribution an atom at the corner is shared by 8 unit cell, contribution 8 unit cell, and from each corner contribution is equal to 1/8. Therefore, the number of atoms present in the unit cell is equal to 8 into 1/8 is equal to 1. Next is the body-centered. In case of body-centered, atoms are present not only at the corner but also present within the body of the unit cell. Okay, so the lattice has 8 atoms on the corner, and 1 atom within the body. Okay, I am repeating, please listen carefully. The lattice has 8 atoms on the corner and 1 atom within the body. Then contribution by 8 atoms present on the corner. Present on the corner is equal to 8 into 1 by 8 is equal to 1. And contribution? And contribution by the atom present within the body. Which is equal to 1. That's why number of atoms present in unit cell is equal to 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. It means from the corner, at the corner, what is the contribution? 1 by 8. Total number is equal to 8. 8 into 1 by 8. And one atom present within the body, which is 1. 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. This is the body-centered cubic. Next one. Last. Face-centered cubic. Face-centered cubic. What is a face-centered cubic? Atoms are not present only at the corner, but also present in the face of the unit cell. Then, this is the face-centered. And there is one phase, two phase, three phase, four phase, five phase, six phase. In your room, you can see they are left, right, top, bottom, and left, right, top, bottom, left, and you can see the four phases in your around, and one is top or other one is in bottom. These are the phases. Okay, then contribution. Like BCC, like SC, contribution by atoms on the corner. You can see in your room, from your room another room is open, and there you have to see your corner of your room, okay, and compare it. 1 by 8 into 8 is equal to 1. And contribution by atoms on the phases, which is 1 by 2, and total number of phases 6 is equal to 3. That's why number of atoms present in the unit cell is equal to 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. What is the 1 by 2? How it comes? 1 by 2 means there is one copy, and there is, suppose this is a one atom. Suppose there is one atom and this is another unit cell. Suppose here is one atom is present. Suppose there is one toffee is present, okay? And this is the unit cell. This is the unit cell and there is one toffee is present. If there is another unit cell, then this toffee is shared by two unit cell. Okay, then what we will write? 1 by 2. Okay, that's why this is 1 by 2. And if this toffee is shared by two unit cell and total number of phases are 6, then 6 is equal to 6 into 1 by 2 is equal to 3. This is the face centered cubic. So students, this is the simple cubic, body centered cubic, face centered cubic. The question is asked total number of atoms per unit cell. You have to calculate the total number of atoms per unit cell. And there one more thing, this value is Z. What is a Z? Z is the total number of atoms per unit cell. In case of SC, 1. In case of BCC, 2. In case of FCC is equal to 4. Always remember, this is the value which we will use in numerical. We will use in this numerical. Okay students, so this is the types of unit cell in case of BCC, FCC and SC. Next topic is calculation of density of a cubic crystal. From its edge, the density of a unit cell. Then we are calculating density of unit cell. The numerical is very frequently asked. This, suppose this is the A, which is edge length. This is edge length. Okay students, then there is small derivation. For cubic crystals, we are going through the cubic crystal system. Edge of the unit cell, edge of unit cell a centimeter, yeah, you can write a picometer. What is the atomic mass of the element? Atomic mass of the element is equal to m. Number of atoms. Number of. You can write here picometer. You can write picometer. You can write centimeter. Number of atoms present per unit cell. Is equal to Z. As I have already told you, what is the Z? Z is the total number of atoms per unit cell. Then what will be the volume of the unit cell? This is the cube, and what will be the volume of unit cell? And we can say what volume of cube, very nice, volume of cube, volume of the unit cell, which is A cube. As we know that the volume of the cube is A cube, and this is a picometer cube. Then it can be converted into centimeter. A cube, picometer cube, we can write A cube into 10 to the power minus 30 centimeter cube. Okay, so this is, we are converting picometer into centimeter. Okay, density of the unit cell. Density of the unit cell is equal to mass of unit cell upon volume of unit cell. And we have already calculated volume of the unit cell. This is the volume of the unit cell. We have only calculate mass of the unit cell. Okay, then mass of the unit cell. देन मास ऑफ द यूनिट सेल, मास ऑफ यूनिट सेल इज इक्वल टू नंबर ऑफ एटम्स इन यूनिट सेल इंटू मास ऑफ ईच एटम. वी हैव टू टेक मास ऑफ ईच एटम. ओके, देन नंबर ऑफ एटम्स इन यूनिट सेल इज इक्वल टू जेड एंड मास ऑफ ईच एटम वी आर टेकिंग स्मॉल एम. ओके, मास ऑफ ईच एटम. If we have to calculate mass of unit cell, then you have to take the total number of atoms. Then we have to know the mass of each atom. What is the mass of each atom? How can we calculate mass of each atom? Which is atomic mass upon Avogadro number. Avogadro number, which is n naught, n naught आप बोल सकते हैं, n zero बोल सकते हैं, which is what is this is Avogadro number. Which is Avogadro number is equal to m upon n naught. Okay. Then we have there we are having mass of each atom. Okay, then density of unit cell, density of unit cell, here is you have written mass of unit cell is equal to number of atoms in unit cell, mass of each atom. Then this is this mass of each atom we can put here z into m upon n naught. Okay, and this is the mass, this is the mass, and what is the volume? Volume we have already discussed. This is the volume, and volume is a cube. I'm writing here 30 centimeter. This is the formula z into m upon n naught a cube into 10 की पावर माइनस 30 सेंटीमीटर ग्राम पर सेंटीमीटर क्यूब. द डेंसिटी ऑफ द सब्सटेंस इज सेम एज दैट ऑफ द डेंसिटी ऑफ द यूनिट सेल. अगेन आई एम टेलिंग यू प्लीज सी वेरी केयरफुली. h दिस इज द h एटॉमिक मास वी आर टेकिंग कैपिटल m. नंबर ऑफ एटम्स वी हैव टू यू हैव ऑलरेडी कैलकुलेट sc bcc fcc इज z. वॉल्यूम ऑफ द यूनिट सेल as we know that the volume of the unit cell is cube and cube volume of cube is a cube which is given in picometer. You have to convert it into centimeter. What is the density of the unit cell? Mass of the unit cell upon volume of the unit cell. And we know the volume of the unit cell but we don't have idea about mass of unit cell. Then we calculate mass of unit cell. What is the mass of unit cell? Number of atoms in unit cell into mass of each atom. Then we calculate mass of each atom. In case of cube, then we are taking mass of each atom, which is atomic mass upon Avogadro number, and this value is put into here. In case of in this here mass of each in place of mass of each atom, then the density of the unit cell is equal to mass upon volume. Volume we have already calculated. This is the mass z into m into n upon n naught a cube into 10 to power minus 30 centimeter. This is the density of the unit cell. This is very important derivation of the density of the unit cell. Always very frequently numerical is asked to you. I am taking one question, one numerical. A face centered cubic element, a face centered cubic element atomic mass 60 has cell edge of 400 पिकोमीटर, कैलकुलेट डेंसिटी. देयर इज वन न्यूमेरिकल. एज वी नो दैट व्हाट विल बी द वैल्यू ऑफ जेड इन न्यूमेरिकल, व्हाट इज गिवन, फेस सेंटर्ड. इट मीन्स वैल्यू ऑफ जेड इज इक्वल टू 4 एंड डेंसिटी इज इक्वल टू z into m upon a cube into n naught. All of you know what is n naught. N naught is the Avogadro number. What is the value of Avogadro number? 6.023 into 10 ki power into 10 ki power 23. Okay, 10 ki power minus 30. Put all the values. 4. Atomic mass is given 60, H is 400 picometer, then 400 thrice into 6.023 into 10 ki power 23. Never be confused here. Always remember Avogadro number is 6.023 into 10 ki power 23 into 10 ki power minus 30. Okay, and answer 6.23 gram per centimeter cube. This is the answer. You all of you calculate in your copy. Okay, so this is the all about today's lecture. Okay, this is the solid state crystalline solid, amorphous solid, space lattice, unit cell, types of unit cell, calculation of total number of atoms of per unit cell in simple cubic, BCC, in FCC, this is FCC centered cubic, and the calculation of density of a unit cell. This is a small derivation, and this is the one numerical I've told you. Okay, then this is all about solid state. All of you, you have to solve all the numericals. If you have any query, please revert back to me. Okay, thank you.